you for joining us today. We trust that you will be motivated, challenged, and inspired by this week's message. Let's join Mike now.
But our key phrase for the series reminds us, nothing is always, so never say never. See, sometimes we have to understand, in order for things to get better, they often have to get worse first. God invariably works in unorthodox ways, doing unexpected things. He's an unorthodox God. I love the fact that although Habakkuk doesn't understand what God's doing, he reminds himself of who God is. And it's a reminder to us, when we don't understand what God's doing, we need to remember who God is. This is where so many people go wrong. Because it's at this point they will conclude, it must mean that there's no God. Because God's not like this. Or they say, I just can't believe this because God won't explain it to me. And if he won't explain what he's doing, then I just can't believe him. Why does God have to explain himself? He's God. He don't have to explain himself to anybody. He can do whatever he wants. He owns the world. And he will. See, Habakkuk does the wisest thing. He leaves it with God. And he waits on God. And the best thing we can do when we don't understand what the heck God's doing, when we don't understand God's plan, is to leave it with him and wait on him. See, he knew enough about God's character to trust God's promise, despite the fact that it says he braced himself for the worst. I think there are times when we need to brace ourselves for the worst but believe for the best. I think that the reason we get caught so often is this, that we're believing for the best, but we haven't considered the worst. And sometimes we don't see the best until we've gone through the worst. And then the worst is a shock to us because it's like, well, where is God? God told me it was going to work out different. Yeah, but he didn't say when. Have you noticed that a lot of prophetic words don't have any timing attached to them? I think of words that we have. We were just looking through some words. We're clearing some boxes in the loft, and there are a lot of church words in there, and words spoken over our lives, and amazing what people say. That's all I'm going to say. It's amazing what people put down on paper that you could use as evidence years later, but the grace in you just says, oh, let it go, let it go. Anyway, there are words in that box. And I remember looking back over those words. And one of those words said, and this was a guy who didn't know anything about us. There's a video, we'll maybe show it in church sometime. It'll look a bit old now. We'll look a bit old now. But this guy said, there's a door about to open for you, man of God, that you have never seen open before. About to open. So I thought, about, that's great, about to open. That means like tomorrow, doesn't it? That was about 21 years ago. About to open. It's still about to open. God's about and our about are two different things. So we have to just trust God. And we believe for the best, but we brace ourselves for the worst. Here's God's response. So he's waiting. He's climbed up to his watchtower, not God, Habakkuk. And he's waiting. And this is what he receives. Write my answer plainly on tablets, so that a runner can carry the correct message to others. This vision is for a future time. It describes the end, and it will be fulfilled. If it seems slow in coming, wait patiently, for it will surely take place. It will not be delayed. Now, of course, we know that scripture, but now in context, doesn't it seem to be so much more powerful? Now we know what it was kind of connected to. I'll tell you why it was more powerful. Listen to it. Write the vision plainly, because you're going to forget. And there are going to be other people part of this vision that need to know. They're going to run with it. So make sure it's clear so that the one who's carrying it will know what it's all about. Because it's for a future time. And it will be fulfilled. It's a certainty. Because if it seems slow, wait. Oh. For it will surely take place and it will not be delayed. Now, I'm sure Habakkuk went away from that going, oh, great. I have been waiting and waiting and waiting. And now he says, wait. It's for the future. I think he might have used this phrase, give me a break. See, invariably, when we say what, God says wait. He doesn't always answer the question. Have you noticed that about God? We want to know when. We want to know why. We want to know what. And we want all of it at the same time. But isn't it amazing that we often don't get any of those three things? Or we just get one of those three things, or two out of the three. And we could really do with all three at the same time. Often we have to wait for his what. And what God was essentially saying was, look, the plan will come together, trust me. And the purpose will work out. Because the very thing, and I don't know whether you missed this, when I was talking about the Babylonians, did you catch the little bit at the end? There was a positive. And what God was trying to say to him was, look, the Babylonians trust will prove to be their downfall. Because they trust their very gods. And their very gods will overthrow them. And in time, you will see, in time and on time, my plan and my purpose. But here's the thing. It will be in time and it will be on time, but it will take time. One day. And one day will eventually become today. And what God was really trying to say to him was, look, there's an in-between. And your in-between, you need to trust me. Even though and even when it looks all wrong, because I promise you it will come right. I wonder what your life's looking like right now. Maybe it all looks wrong. It's like, God, come on. Give me a break. I need a breakthrough. God's going, trust me, you're in between. You're in between, here's the thing. We need to trust God in between because you're in between the promise given and the promise fulfilled. The in between is the most difficult time because there's always a gap and we have to mind the gap. What we do in the gap determines what the gap does to us. So in the detail of God's answer, which is quite lengthy and I don't have time to really go through everything, but maybe, you know, in your connect groups, you can study this a little bit more in chapter 2. At the beginning, God shares this statement and confirms a principle that, would you believe, is quoted four times in the Bible, Old and New Testament. He says, but the righteous shall live by their faith. The righteous will live by their faith. In other words, Habakkuk, the way to get through your in-between from the promise given to the promise fulfilled is by faith. No other way. You can try everything, and that's why these Babylonians are going to fail. Because they don't have the faith in me, they have faith in themselves. It's not by reasoning, not by circumstances, or by observation, but by faith. Faith in what God said will happen. I think there's really only two options in life. You either fear it or faith it, or fake it. And Habakkuk's prayer of faith for God's people even though they were small at this point, in the face of such unprecedented challenges, I think still stands today as an incredible witness of undeniable faith and an amazing display of undying hope. And I love the fact that it says in one of the versions that what I'm about to read in a few moments is a prayer of Habakkuk the prophet set to wild, enthusiastic, and triumphal music. That kind of sums us up. Someone said the other day, they were describing our church, they said wild music. I like wild music. I was watching, Planet Shaker's got a new album coming out, by the way. Just letting you know. It's not, you can't pre-order it. Yeah, I've tried. Oh, it's amazing. If you get to watch the preview, jump on planetshakersmusic.com, I think it is. There's a plug for Planet Shakers if you're in Australia. If you're watching from Planet Shakers, I'll receive the bonus later. Anyway. They were saying about their album and their worship and when they recorded it, that it's over the top because our God is over the top. Yeah. I love that. Yeah. God is over the top. Yeah. He is extravagant. So our worship should be over the top. Our church should be over the top. You know, one thing that people say when they come into our church, and it's happened so many times when I've got into conversation with people afterwards, they go, wow, there is definitely a wow factor to your church. You know, it's like you make an impression. The moment you come in, that you know, it's like, whoa. It's a bit of a surprise first. Yeah. We got to keep doing that. Yes, because we serve a God that always wows us and impresses us. Yes, see, Habakkuk reminds us that our faith isn't blind. It's not blind faith. It's not stupid. Because it rests on what the certainty of what God has already done. And there's plenty of evidence of God working in our past and our present to give us hope for our future. Loads of evidence. When people say, oh, I don't know where God is. Oh, come on. Can't you remember what he did last? This is why we need to bring to memory. Psalmist talked about that. Remember his benefits. Remember what God has done. Remember the blessings in your life. See, we're on to the next one. Oh, God, yeah, you did that yesterday, thanks. Now we're on to this one. Now I need this. We got a shopping list as long as our arm. And God's going, well, if I did it then, I can do it now. And I can do it then. So why are you not believing me today just because you're in between? You've been in between before, but you forgot about that bit. All you remember is the blessing after the in-between. The whole point you went in between was to teach you how to be stronger this time in between. So he recalls God's greatness and remembers God's power. And he says these most amazing words. Even though the fig trees have no blossoms and there are no grapes on the vines, even though the olive crop fails and the fields lie empty and barren, even though the flocks die in the fields and the cattle barns are empty, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in the God of my salvation. The sovereign Lord is my strength. He makes me as sure-footed as a deer, able to tread upon the heights. Don't get too excited right now. Even though there's no money in the bank and the debts are piling up, even though there's no food in the cupboard and we can't afford to go to the supermarket, even though there's no petrol in the car, even though the car needs a service, even though I haven't seen this happen and that happen and the other happen, yet I will trust God. Yet I will give God praise. Yet I will always every single moment of my life. Thank God for the incredible things he's done, he's doing, and will do. That's the right attitude to have. That's faith right there. Because there's loads of even those there. And I'm sure there are a load more too. I'm sure he just picked the best ones for us. And it's what I've been sharing the last 2 weeks. Even when and even though. See, you might be saying that today. Even when and even though. Yet I will. Will you? Even when it doesn't make sense. And even though it doesn't all work out. Will you? I will if you will. Let's stand. It's a good question, isn't it? Will you? If you will, then I'd be so honored to lead you in a personal prayer of commitment. If there's anybody here that has never done that, or if there's anybody watching online, either on Periscope, or if you're watching tomorrow, which is Monday, which will be today if you're watching tomorrow. Now I've confused you. Confused myself too. But if you're in tomorrow watching this back, it's not too late to pray this prayer. No. If you're watching live now on Periscope, or you're watching while it's still Sunday and you've got 24 hours on Periscope to watch, so you might watch it at a later stage, and you have never prayed a prayer of commitment, can I lead you? I'd be so honored to lead you in a prayer. Even though it doesn't make sense. Even though it doesn't all kind of work out. But you just feel like, I need to do this. I need to put my faith somewhere in someone. Because I can't live the way I've been living. If that's you, can I lead you in this prayer? If you're in the house and you've never prayed, would you pray this with me and say, Lord, today I say I will. I will trust you with my life, even though it doesn't all make sense. I've been challenged through this message that when we don't understand what you're doing, we need to remember who you are. You are God. And now I want to make you my God. I'm sorry for my past, and I ask for your forgiveness as I put my trust in you, thanking you for all you've done and believing for all you're going to do. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to ask, did anybody pray that prayer in the house first? Never prayed a prayer of commitment before. Wonder whether there's anybody online. If there is, then would you let us know so that we can continue to pray for you and we can connect you to a good church wherever you are in the world. There are good churches, I think pretty much everywhere now. And it's really important that you connect with a local church. It's one thing to watch us on Periscope, and I'm so glad you tuned in. But I think, you know, being part of a local church and really developing as a believer is so important. Don't just, you know, start this journey and get stuck here, but actually develop your life in God, because then you will see the promises of God come to fruition. Maybe today you already know God, but you just feel like you need to retrust him. Maybe you think, well, you know what? I've been a bit like Habakkuk. I can kind of relate to this guy. I've got a bit frustrated with God. In fact, I probably went a bit further than he did and started to allow my frustration to turn into anger, because it's like, God, why haven't you done the things that you've promised? And I feel like God is saying to you today, I am. I have, and I am doing them. They are still working out in your life. Never say never. It's just you don't recognize them. Because you don't recognize the people that I'm using. You've actually even written off some of the people that I wanted to use. My God, you can use them? Really? You know what they've done and what they're doing? God used a donkey to speak to one guy in the Bible because he was so stubborn. God can use anybody. He's not looking for someone who's perfect to speak into your life. So it's not all going to be neatly packaged so that you'll go, oh yes, I was waiting for you, prophet so-and-so. He's going to use someone and you're going to go, you, all right, I'm listening. Yeah, your attitude needs to change before, because you won't receive a word unless you're actually ready to receive from that person. God can use anybody. If you've been challenged today by the message, I guess it's been challenging, but hopefully it's been encouraging.
Yes, amen.
Would you pray this prayer as well? And if you're online, take the opportunity to retrust in God again. And say, Lord, today I've been reminded that in order for things to get better, they often have to get worse first. And the best thing we can do when we don't understand your plan is leave it with you and wait on you. Lord, I need to trust you in between the promise given and the promise fulfilled. So help me, Lord, to mind the gap, so that even when and even though, yet I will. In Jesus' name, amen. Did anybody pray that in the house today? Fantastic. Love to see hands going up in the house in response to God's word. And if you prayed that online, we want to stand shoulder to shoulder with you, believe with you as you continue your journey. Would you let us know? Contact us by email, contact us by one of the ways that you can, either on our app, our website, on Facebook, on Twitter, on Periscope, and all of the above. And we want to help you in whatever way we can to keep developing and turning into the kind of person that God is looking for you to be, which is full of faith, full of hope, because you have a great future ahead of you.
Amen.
The best is yet to come.
We hope you have enjoyed today's message. To download further resources, click on the resources icon. If this message has impacted your life, we would love to hear from you. So don't forget to join us next week for another inspiring message.